위력적인 발차기를 배워보겠는데 얼마 전 태권내대에서 네티즌들을 대상으로 어떤 발차기가 가장 위력적인가 여기에 대한 질문에 많은 네티즌들이 대답한 발차기가 바로 뒤차기입니다. 그렇습니다. 뒤차기 또는 몸 돌려 뒤차기라 하는데 우선 몸을 돌려 옆차기 하는 것을 몸 돌려 옆차기라 하고 몸을 돌려 뒤차기 하는 것을 몸 돌려 뒤차기라 합니다. 여러분들이 많이 알고 있는 것처럼 이 두 가지 방법을 통틀어 뒤차기라고 칭합니다. 그럼 뒤차기에 대해 설명하겠습니다.
From the ready position, shift your weight to the front. Pull your hip back a little and turn the upper body a little. At this moment, lift both heels and turn them 160 to 170 degrees. Place your sight to the front over your left shoulder. Second, lift the right foot and position it next to the knee of the supporting leg. Turn the upper body a little more so that you can see behind your back, and place your eyes to the front over the right shoulder. Be careful of the angle and shape of the foot lifted, the pulling and turning degree of the upper body, and the knee of the supporting leg, the angle of the lifted foot. Second, raise your kicking foot up to the inside knee of the supporting foot. At this moment, be careful that the lifted foot does not go outward. If the lifted foot goes out at all, the hip turns and slips back. And because of this, you can't stretch out your leg powerfully the moment you should kick. You should move the upper body to an angle of 45 to 70 degrees when you raise your knee and kick. At this angle, you can throw an accurate kick with ease. Further, don't turn the right shoulder too much forward toward the front when you turn your upper body. If you turn your shoulder too much, you may not be able to stretch your foot successfully to the target. The moment you make this motion, the knee of the supporting leg needs to be bent a little. This is to help you react to any following situation and bounce the knee to kick strongly. Next, stretch the heel to kick as the kicking foot grazes the left knee of the supporting leg. The point of this is to stretch the foot straight to the target at the second step. Finally, drag the kicking foot back to the initial position and get ready. At the ready position, as in the round side kick, load your weight forward, pull your hip back a little, and turn your upper body a touch. At this moment, lift and turn both heels at 160 to 170 degrees. Make sure your eyes are faced to the front over the left shoulder. Second, turn the body to the front, but turn your eyes there first quickly, and then rotate your body. When your body turns 270 degrees, take the side kick pose. Third, stretch out the heel or foot blade to kick. This is the same point as the side kick, but unlike the basic side kick, the round side kick involves the upper body turning. So if you miss the timing of the kick, the hip slips back. Therefore, try to make the kick as if kicking a little earlier. Finally, put down the kicking foot on the front and drag it back to the initial ready position.
뒤차기를 몸돌려 뒤차기와 몸돌려 옆차기로 나누어서 배워보았습니다. 이 발차기는 회전을 직선으로 바꿔차기 때문에 강력한 파워를 내게 됩니다. 다른 발차기에 비해 실전에서 자연스레 사용할 수가 있는 발차기가 되겠습니다. 회전과 직선의 힘을 적절하게 갖추었기 때문에 뒤차기가 위력적이고 자연스럽게 사용될 수 있는 것입니다. 그러나 돌거나 회전할 때 안정적인 자세와 균형이 나오지 않으면 제대로 힘을 실어서 찰 수가 없고 동작이 커서 반격당하기가 쉽습니다. 뒤차기 시 뒤로 돌았을 때 먼저 보고 차는 부분과 엉덩이가 빠지지 않도록 차는 부분을 신경 써서 연습을 해야 합니다. 강력한 발차기 수컷은 뒤차기 방법을 살펴보도록 하겠습니다.
This exercise is to help beginners get balance for performing the back kick. As I've shown before, you must separate submotions and practice each one slowly while holding the chair. This exercise is to help you kick as fast as athletes. When you turn from the ready position to do the back kick, draw in your shoulder to soothe your upper body and place your sight to the front over your shoulder. This reduces the turning breadth of the shoulder and makes it easier to transform into a straight line and to kick faster. Take a step back and back kick. This exercise is to counterattack your opponent. Place the right foot forward, move it back, and execute the back kick right away. Begin with separate motions and practice each slowly. Take both feet back and back kick. With the kicking foot behind, take both feet back and execute the back kick. Cross feet and back kick. With the kicking foot ahead, cross your feet quickly and execute the back kick. You follow up the distance that is made as the opponent steps back. All the motions are the same as the back kick, but the moment you turn, bend the knee of the supporting foot and jump on it. At the same time, follow up kicking. The key point in this kick is to kick and jump with proper timing.